Good afternoon, Jim Thalman, coming from London today. I mean, the festival itself is one of these fests that you've heard of all your career. You've had friends that have been at it, and it's this kind of legendary, iconic festival that when we got word, I told my wife immediately, I'm like, we're going. We got to see some great movies. It's an awesome fest. It's got a history and a pedigree that we were thrilled. I play the lead detective investigating the murder of this beautiful cabaret singer by the name of Diane. Now, this young woman is found barely dressed with one puncture wound in the backyard of the weird guy on the block. The one that drinks too much and fights too much and argues with everyone and has no friends, no family, no history, no job, no anything. He looks good for the crime in every way, shape, or form. But something just isn't fitting. There's no DNA evidence. There's no, there's nothing placing him or the deceased together in any way, shape, or form. Now, what happens that's really interesting is as the investigation unfolds, so does Steve, him, his mind. So now he starts having these very intimate conversations or fantasies or hallucinations with the murdered girl. She's all of a sudden in his living room having a conversation with him. So now we don't know, is he batshit crazy or is he seeing a ghost? Well, which is which? And as the story unfolds, the aha moment comes where there's a lot of back and forth of like, is he, isn't it? It's a wonderful payoff.
If you had to describe for fans what they can expect overall from the tone of the film, the type of suspense, can you do that?
Creepy, doubtful, inside your head. Am I crazy? Did I really just see that? Wait a second. This something is off, kind of. Creep up your spine, like, I don't know about, what is, I don't know about this. That kind of. Think about it. The oral tradition since the dawn of time has always been stories that kind of scare you into some type of morality or submission or belief system. And I think our films are still the ones that push the envelope and do things that other genres are not doing. And if you look at it, even just horror films over the past 5 or 6 decades, they start independently. The really radical done by the guys that don't have two nickels to rub together, but they do have a camera and a mic and a couple of friends that want to make a movie, and they get experimental. And every time horror as a whole, or every time the film industry's gone through a major shift, horror was at the forefront. And if you think about it, you know, in the early 80s with the Halloweens and the Friday the 13th to the 90s, you know, to the 90s with the Blair Witches and the, you know, the whatever, what was that? 2006 was, what the hell was that one? It was a couple staying at a house in San Diego, and they can't sleep, and they put the video recorder.
That was Paranormal Activity, everyone, for those playing along at home.
Circuitous route of getting to Paranormal. I'll tell you a quick story about that. So I'm sitting, I got like a 2 a.m. ticket in L.A. I'm in L.A. at the time, right? And I'm sitting next to this guy, and this guy next to me was one of those gigantic, muscular, like big, big, giant guys with muscles like this. And the one moment comes, and I'm not going to deny it, I jumped out of my seat as well. But this guy jumped out of his seat and shrieked like a teenager. Like you would not believe. And it was the funniest moment. And I always remember that moment in that movie.